Having done and dusted Orlando City, Atlanta United take on a dangerous NYCFC this weekend. Let's discuss how we can get all 3 points next. What's going on, Five Track fam? I'm AJ, and thanks for joining me. Before we get started, become a member of the Notification Squad on YouTube by hitting the bell next to the subscribe button. Or if you're on Facebook, hit that like and follow button. Welcome to a match preview special. It's a Sunday matinee at the Benz as we take on the Pigeons on Big ESPN. Now, in terms of the Pigeons, they've had a pretty good run of late. Decent anyway. It's 3 wins and 3 losses in their last 6. They just beat Houston Dynamo 3-2 at Yankee Stadium. So they have an encouraging win in their toe, although they just played on Thursday and they will play again on Sunday. So we could take advantage of some fatigue as they play 3 games in 8 days. Now, in terms of Atlanta, we've won 3, drawn 1, and lost 2 in our last 6. In terms of previous matchups against NYCFC, we've fared pretty evenly against them, although we eke it out with that 2018 playoff win. And in terms of record, we're 3 wins, 2 draws, and 1 loss against them. NYCFC are up to 3rd in the Eastern Conference, and with only 22 matches played, they're only 1 point behind Atlanta United. I think NYCFC have every chance to win the East as well. They've got 3 games in hand on Philadelphia Union. They've got a goal difference of 11, just under us at 12. And with 38 points, again, they are only 4 points off of Philadelphia Union. Now, in terms of strengths, NYCFC like to create their chances through counterattacks and through balls. And we have to be very wary of their long shot because it is very deadly. They're also very good at coming back from losing positions. But something we can attack is that they're not very good at protecting their lead. And so if they do get up, we do have a chance to get back in the game. They also have a problem with stopping opponents from creating chances. They can't avoid fouling in dangerous areas, and defending set pieces and aerial duels, they're not too good at. In terms of players to watch, Maxi Morales, their creative midfielder, has 6 goals and 13 assists. Now, I think Eric Rometty or Mo Adams will have their hands full of marking this really pest of a player. In terms of another danger man, Ford Ebert has 9 goals and 2 assists. And midfielder and their captain, Alexander Ring, has 4 goals and 4 assists. They've really spread the goals around on NYCFC's squad, and so it'll be very paramount to be stout defensively. In terms of their injured or unavailable players, their head coach, Domi Torrent, will be without 3 first-team players, most likely, Joe Scali, Ishmael Tajiri-Shradi, and Ben Sweat. Scali remains sidelined after hip surgery, while Tajiri-Shradi is still recovering from an ankle injury. Ben Sweat is out with a back injury after being subbed out in the 17th minute versus RSL last Saturday. As for Atlanta, Jose Martinez is day-to-day with a grade 2 adductor strain that he suffered in Monday's training session. Brandon Vasquez is also unlikely to feature as he's still recovering from his own adductor strain. So let's get to some of the match facts. Atlanta United have kept a clean sheet in 8 of their last 10 home matches in MLS. And Atlanta United have won 9 of their last 10 home games during that same span. And we've been winning at both halftime and full-time in 7 of the last 9 home matches. And we've also scored at least 2 goals in the last 7 home matches. So let's get into some of the keys of the game. We need to get our midfield involved again on the score sheet. PT Martinez and Ezequiel Barco were pretty well marked last match, and so they weren't able to get on the score sheet as the strikers, but Eric Rometty was able to get involved and really was the match winner and made the difference against Orlando City. Although NYCFC like to play with the ball and have a fair amount of possession as well, we need to take advantage of the possession and finish our chances. We also need to make it count, as they foul a lot in dangerous areas, and so if we get a free kick or corner, let's take advantage. But also, if they get a lead, let's not get too down because we can come back with a bit of belief because they are a team that is pretty susceptible to giving up their lead. And finally, we need to stay steady against their counterattack, and we need to close down quickly against their patented long shots. So how are we gonna line up? Let's get into our predicted starting lineup. I think we're gonna play a 3-5-2 as we have to pretty decent effect recently. I think Guzan starts between the sticks, and I think a LGP actually starts at the right center back. We have Miles Robinson in the middle of the back three, and we have a Florentine Pogba as the left center back. Now you might be wondering where our Franco Escobar is. We'll get into that in a second, but I think Julian Gressel is that right wing back, and I think Franco Escobar is that left wing back, as he played a little bit in that position against Orlando City. Eric Rometty and Donovan Nagby return in those center midfielder positions, and Emerson Hyman, I think, returns to that 10 position. And I think a PT Martinez and an Ezequiel Barco return to the striker positions up top. I think Tito Villalba getting a run out against Orlando City on Tuesday bodes well, and he will get another run out, I think, on Sunday, spelling one of the two strikers up top. Now getting into our score prediction, it's going to be a pretty tight one, I think. NYCFC have been playing pretty decently, and I think they'll be pretty tough in this one and will be up for this match. But I think ultimately it will be a 2-2 draw with maybe a Franco Escobar goal, maybe a header from him from one of the set pieces, and maybe a PT Martinez on the score sheet. I think this kind of game really bodes well for a PT Martinez, as the technicality of what his play really encompasses can, I think, break through against an NYCFC defense. So that's the match preview. Leave us your score predictions in the comments below. And remember to subscribe if you haven't already, smash that like button, and share this video because it really does help us a lot. And I'll see you in the next video.